idea for Cat Person in, I think, April of 2017. I was newly single again after having been in a relationship for most of my 20s. And I guess I had the idea that now that I was in my 30s and I had my feet under me, it would be somehow easier, that all the miscommunications and sort of minor difficulties would be smoothed away. And it turned out that that is not what happened. It was in some ways just as hard. And I started thinking, you know, how would I have dealt with the way the world is now when I was younger, when I was just 20, 21. And so that was sort of the origin. I had been on one bad date that had nothing to do with the actual events in the story, but where there was that same feeling at the end of like, oh, did I invent a person out of thin air? Like, I'm angry that this person isn't who I thought they were, but I am the one who made up that story. And so that was the idea that sort of sparked the writing of the story. When you're writing a short story, and especially for me, you know, where it was, I'd only had a handful of stories published before, you're really thinking that maybe a handful of people will read it and care about it. And even that is wonderful, right? And so for the story first to be accepted to the New Yorker, which was a dream of mine, was huge. And then to watch as all these different people, different women, sort of from a bunch of different backgrounds, many of whom I think weren't short story readers, just finding it and responding it and sharing their feelings, it was incredible. It was unlike anything I had ever experienced before, and really more than I could possibly have imagined. I think power is at the heart of all of the stories. When I was putting the collection together and I was looking at everything I'd written and trying to decide what to put in and what to take out, I really wanted there to be this central focus on power dynamics and also on really intense one-on-one relationships. So the majority of the stories do focus on romantic relationships. Most of them are between men and women. There are a handful that are, you know, there's one that's between a mother and a daughter, but it's that same sort of intense push-pull of people trying to figure out sort of where do I end and the other person begins. When I was growing up, I was a kind of omnivorous reader. I would read in the fantasy section, and then the horror section, and then the young adult section. And all of those stories kind of came together and mixed together in a way that shaped my understanding of what the world was like and what it would be like to grow up. And I wanted to create a collection that had that same kind of fluidity that had so many different variety of stories that when you started a new one, you weren't quite sure what the stakes were. And that would let you feel like anything could happen, right? Like this bad date might just end in a miscommunication, or it might end in a monstrosity, and you don't know. And I feel like that uncertainty adds a kind of tension to all the stories, even the ones that aren't fantastical.